Welcome, everybody, to this week's edition of Valpo Basketball Weekly, brought to you by Lakeshore Bone and Joint Institute. Brandon Vickery with you. Glad to be joined by the head coach of the Valpo Women's Basketball Program, Mary Evans. And Coach, finally back in action this past weekend after a long layoff. Just how did you approach that extended period of time without a game? And then what was it like to finally be back on the court in a game situation?
It felt really good to be back on the court. I think the players were excited to be back. We tried to get as much practices in as we could while also giving our kids some time off to, recoup mentally and physically. We brought some officials in one day, played an inter-squad scrimmage to try to maintain some game conditioning over that weekend that we didn't play, but just tried to work on some things. It was kind of nice to have a break and be able to kind of get back to the basics with a lot of our players. We've obviously introduced a lot of new faces since Christmas break, and they've been kind of learning on the fly, so we were able to get back to some basics and teach some of our offensive and defensive principles a lot better and in more detail with that time that we had.
I know you've been asked this question this weekend, but it's that time of year to talk about the senior class. Just what was it like to get the chance to recognize them this weekend, and what has this class meant to your program?
Yeah, it was awesome. I mean, I think obviously COVID has thrown kind of a wrench into a lot of plans this year, including typically how we celebrate senior night. But I think my staff, led by Kaylin, did a fantastic job with the ideas and the things that we were able to do with them. And, they've meant a ton. I think, Kaylin and Marley were some of the older kids. When I got here, Ella was just coming off of her freshman year. And, they've meant so much to me personally. They've meant so much to this program. They've been, in the trenches for the last 3 years. They're hopefully the last class that's really going to remember, losing a lot. At least that's the hope, right? And they've kind of gone through that. And I think their fire and their energy and wanting to change that and their commitment to getting better and their commitment to kind of changing the culture of this program is huge. And, I'm going to miss them dearly when they're gone.
On the flip side of some of those veteran players who have been around for quite a while, you have newcomers that have just joined your program, seniors in high school this year, graduate early, get a chance mm-hmm. to come join the team. Just what's it been like to integrate the mid-year enrollees into your program, and what are some long-term benefits to having them here, part of your program, part of your system, a semester early?
Yeah, I think it's going to be really, really beneficial for them. I think just being on a campus and being back in person learning, being around people is going to be huge. And, I think just getting that sneak peek into our program, is going to be great. I mean, they're in practice every day. No offense to any of their high school programs, but, competing against other college players day in and day out is going to make you better, probably better than even playing in your high school season. Now, those two are not going to have the opportunity to play. Mostly, I think Illinois now has started playing, but obviously they missed out on a significant amount of practice and playing here this year. And so I think it's going to be great for them. They're getting, like I said, a sneak peek. They're going to understand things a little bit better than the two young ladies that are finishing up their senior year. As summer starts, they're getting in the weight room. They're kind of getting acclimated to what our weight room situation's like, how we work. And so I think it's going to be extremely beneficial for both of them moving forward. And the nice part of what's happened this year is that they get this year back. So, we were able to get them some minutes this weekend, and they get some game experience in the Missouri Valley, which I think is super, super important. And I don't think anything is greater than experience. Talent is a wonderful, wonderful thing. But as you play in your conference, as you play college basketball, you just gain experiences and you just can't rush that. And so for them to get some extra time and some extra experiences are going to be really important moving forward.
Well, as we look forward here, the next five games, all on the road after you haven't been on the road in a while, just what do you hope to take away from these final five games of the regular season? What are some things that you're looking for during this stretch from your team?
Yeah, I think, you know, we're just trying to continue, I think, to get better offensively. That's been a big focus. You know, I think we've kind of been a little stagnant here the last couple of weeks. I thought we kind of came out of that a little bit in the second game against Evansville, and we want to build on that. We want to continue to attack people. We want to share the basketball. We want to move the basketball. We want to have great player movement and great ball movement, and try to work together as a group of five to get the best shot that we can get. And I think, like I said, I thought we took some steps forward in that last game on Saturday, and we're hoping to continue that throughout the next five games and play the best we can and see where we can be heading into Moline.
In a normal year, this would be the normal situation as far as Loyola is concerned. You played him a while ago, now you get to play him again. This year, that's the exception rather than the rule to have some time to look back at that first game. What are some improvements you want to make from that home loss, and how do you turn it around at Gentile Arena on Wednesday?
Yeah, you know, I think we want to try to defend. I think we defended them pretty well here. I don't think there's a ton of adjustments that we need to make. We need to be better at our closeouts. We need to do a better job of collectively, again, as a group of five, kind of keeping them out of our paint and rebounding the basketball. Offensively, I think, you know, what we just talked about, like, we got into a little bit, we missed some shots. We got really stagnant offensively. We stopped moving the ball. We started settling, just trying to play one-on-one basketball, and the rest of the players just stopping and staring and watching those players. And so, you know, I think it kind of plays into what we're trying to work on, which is playing better team basketball, moving the basketball, being aggressive and finishing through physicality. And I think, you know, those are going to be things that we're going to need to do at a much higher rate than we did the first time around to have a chance to be in the game. And I'm looking forward to the challenge, and our players are looking forward to getting back out and having an opportunity to play again.
Well, it's an exciting time of year, almost March on the calendar. Good luck the rest of the way here as we close out the regular season.
All right. Thanks, Brandon.
There she is, the head coach of the Valpo Women's Basketball Program, Mary Evans. Once again, this is Valpo Basketball Weekly, and it's brought to you by Lakeshore Bone and Joint Institute. And for all the latest in Valpo Athletics, you can follow us on social media or check out valpoathletics.com.